Hello, magandang araw na naman sa ating lahat. Para sa araw na to, para sa ating session, we're going to talk about volume of solid figures. And of course, meron tayong explanation and real life examples. So, let's go. Ang agad natin. Define muna natin, ano bang volume? What is volume? Okay, volume is the quantity of three-dimensional space enclosed by a closed surface. For example, the space that a substance or shape occupies or contains. Okay, so yun ang volume. Ang volume is measured by quantifying or using the number of cubic units derived from the measurements of respective dimensions of solid figures following certain formulas. Okay, remember, ang bawat solid figure natin para makuha ang volume, may kanya-kanyang formula yan. Mamaya makikita natin ang ating mga formulas. And the general formula for volume is the area of the base multiplied by the height of the solid figure. Ngayon, dito muna tayo. Meron tayong mga solid figures dito. So for example, ito ay isang rectangular prism. Okay, ito rectangular prism natin. Okay, kung mapapansin nyo, meron tayong mga cubes dyan. Okay, yun na yung tinatawag natin cubic units. Yun na yung tinatawag natin cubic units. So for this one, for this sample, meron tayong 6 cubic units. Okay, ito naman, itong isang figure natin sa baba. Okay, so itong isang three-dimensional figure na ito, so meron siyang 3 layers, so tatlong magkakapatong na 4 na cubic units. So therefore, ito ay 12 cubic units. Kasi 4, 4, at saka 4 dito. So ang total nito will be 12 cubic units. Then, ito naman sa kabila, sa upper right hand corner natin. So kung nakikita natin dito, kung saan nakikita, meron tayong 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 cubic units. Tapos, merong dalawang sets. Okay, so therefore, ito ay merong 12 cubic units. Okay, ito naman. Yes, meron tayong 5 cubic units. Then dito, meron tayong another 5 cubic units. Ito, dito sa baba, 6 cubic units. And this one, meron tayong 5 cubic units. Okay? So, yan. Yan ang mga samples ng cubic units. So, yun na yung volume. Okay? Sa madaling salita, ang volume actually ay yung kayang i-contain ng isang solid figure dun sa kanyang loob, dun sa loob. Okay? Eh kung mapapansin niyo, merong mga yung mga bottles may nakalagay na 1 liter. Okay, may nakalagay na 5 milliliters. Okay, yun yung volume niya. Okay? Okay, so let's go. Ito, bawa ito, volume of a cube. Okay, sapos tayo, volume of a cube. So, itong cube na to, so itong figure na ito, it represents a cube. It shows a cube. Okay, tingnan natin. Okay, volume of cube is equal to S times S times S. Or, volume is equal to S raised to 3 or S cube. Wherein, S is the length of one side. Remember, pag cube, lahat ng side na yan, sa baba man yan, yung height niya man yan, yung length niya man, yung width niya, ay pare-parehas yan. Pag cube. So, kung ito 3 feet, okay, kung ito 3 feet, same as true, kung height niya 3 feet din. Same as true, itong nasa taas niya na ito, 3 feet din. Pwede rin, itong side na ito, okay, yung edge na yan, 3 feet din yan. Okay, dahil nga siya ay cube. So, pag cube, lahat ng dimensions, pare-parehas ang sukat. So, this will be, okay, 3 feet lahat yung dimensions niya. Anong gagawin lang yan? Okay, find the volume of a box whose side is 3 feet. Okay, we have here, volume is equal to S times S times S. And we have 3 times 3 times 3, which is equal to 27 cubic feet. Okay, remember this unit, cubic feet. Cubic feet. Teacher, bakit po feet na? Okay, kasi may nakalagay na rito feet. Pag walang nakalagay dyan na unit, di cubic units lang. Pero for this one, we have here cubic feet. Next. Okay? Cubic feet. Next, this one. Okay? Our refrigerator, our fridge, it resembles a rectangular prism. Okay? Volume of rectangular prism is equal to LWH. Wherein, L is equal to length, W is width, and H is height. So, for this one, we are going to find for the volume of the refrigerator on the right. Okay, again, volume is equal to LWH. Okay, so 2 times 1.5 times 5. What if napagpalit natin? So, for example, itong 2, okay, yung 2 at yung 1.5 napagpalit natin. Dito, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Hindi mapapalitan ang sagot natin yan. So, 2 times 1.5 times 5, the answer is 15. Okay, again, that is our unit cubic feet. Kasi feet. Okay? Okay, we have 15 cubic feet. Next, this one. Volume of a triangular prism. This one again. We have a triangular prism here. Let's have the formula. It's equal to 1/2 LWH. 1/2 LWH. Kung mapapansin nyo, balik tayo rito sa rectangular prism, LWH. LWH. Pagpunta natin sa triangular prism, 1/2 LWH. Okay. Remember, bayad din sa area, ang isang triangle actually ay kalahati ng isang rectangle. So same as true here. Yung 1/2 LWH, okay, dahil triangular yung ating base, multiply mo sa 1/2. Pwede rin, gamitin mo, okay, LWH over 2. Length times width times height over 2. So, ito din yung representation natin. And remember, pag sinabing height ng triangle, hindi ito yun. It's not this one. It's not this one. Hindi yan yun. Okay, hindi yan yun. Pag sinabing height ng triangle, from the base ng triangle hanggang dun sa taas ng triangle. Okay? So, ito. Also, mapapansin nyo, ito yun. Okay, yan ang ating height ng ating triangle. Okay. Now, find the volume of the figure on the right. Okay, we have now LWH over 2. Okay? So, 12. Natin times 4, okay, yung base ng triangle mo, times the height of your triangle, which is 6, then divided by 2. Pero gawin muna natin para mas madali, 12 times 4 times 6 equals 288. So 288 over 2, we have 144 cubic centimeters, okay, cubic centimeters. Okay, let's have the next example. Wait naman tayo. Volume of a square pyramid. Okay, square pyramid. So, pag square pyramid, okay, remember, pag sinabi square, so parehas ang dimensions. Kung ito 6, dahil ang base mo ay square, kung ito 6, 6 din ito. Okay? The formula, 1/3 times S times S times H. Pwede mas madali, S times S times H over 3. Wherein, our S is the side of the base. Side of the base. Pag 6 dan, sabi ko 6 dan yan. And the height. Height ng alin? Height ng ating pyramid. Remember, ano ang height? From the base hanggang doon sa pinakataas. Okay? Hindi itong linyang ito. Okay, not that one. Kasi edge yan. Okay, ang height mo is from the base hanggang dito sa tuktok o sa vertex ng iyong pyramid. Okay, let's go. Okay, find the volume of the figure on the right. S times S times H over 3. We have 6 and 6 times 9 over 3. We multiply 6 times 6 times 9. Okay, we have 324. And we divide it by 3. becomes 108 cubic inches. Okay, cubic inches na yun. Yan, inches yung bigay dito. Okay, let's put that in cubic inches. Let's go. Next. Okay, cylinder. Okay, so ito cylinder natin. Okay, cylinder. The formula is pi r squared h. Wherein, okay, r is the radius of the circular base. Okay, radius ng circular base natin. Ito yung ating circular base. Ang radius niya is from the center papunta dun sa ating sa circle mismo. One of the points on the circle. So, from the center of your circle to one of the points on the circle. Remember, as we have learned during our past lessons, ang radius mo, so pag ito 3, same as true, from the center, kahit dito sa kabila, 3 din yun. Okay? And the radius doesn't change. Okay? Iisa lang ang radius natin, kahit saan mo po ipunta na points yan. Basta nasa center ito, automatic, pag ipupunta mo dun sa surface ng circle mo, pare-parehas lang yun. Okay, let us find the volume of the drinking glass on the right side. Okay. We have pi r raised to 2 times h. Okay, ginamit natin 3.14 pi. Remember, 3.14 ang ating pi. Yan ay approximate lang. Okay, medyo mahaba pa yan. Sometimes we use 3.1416. Pero for this example, let us just use 3.14. Okay, we just round off to the nearest 2 decimal places. Okay, 2 decimal places. We have 3.14 times 3 raised to 2 times 8. Okay, applying now our PEMDAS rule, we are going to extract first our exponent. And that makes it 9. So 3.14 times 9 times 8. And we have 226.08 cubic centimeters. Okay, dahil centimeters ito, cubic centimeters tayo. Okay, next. Let's move on. Very good. Really good. Volume of a cone. Next. Okay, it's 1/3 pi r squared h. Okay, kung mapapansin nyo, balik tayo dito. Volume of a cylinder is pi r squared h. Dito tayo sa ating volume of a cone, it's 1/3 pi r squared h. Or pi r square h over 3. Okay? So, kumbaga, parang kinuha mo lang yung volume ng cylinder over 3. Okay? Anyway, pwede nyo balikan itong video natin at pwede nyo i-list down yung ating formulas. Okay, napakalaga ng ating formulas. Radius is equal, where r is equal to the radius of the circular base. Okay? Same. R, circular base natin. Okay, h is your height. Height ng ating cone. Remember, sabi natin kanina, ano ang height? From the lowest part, from the base of your figure hanggang dun sa pinakataas, sa pinakatuktok ng iyong figure. Yun yung ating height. Okay? Let's go. Okay, we find for the volume of this figure. Pi r squared h over 3. 3.14 times 3 raised to 2 times 7 over 3. Again, PEMDAS rule. Exponent muna tayo. 3.14 times 9 times 7 over 3. So, yung ating 3 squared naging 9. Okay, let's go. So, yung minultiply muna natin. 3.14 times 9 times 7. Okay, same as true, sabi ko, itong 3.14 natin ay hindi yan yung eksakto na value ng pi. Nag-round off lang tayo sa 2 decimal places. Okay. So, we have 197.82 over 3. And finally, the answer is 65.94 cubic centimeters. Okay, centimeters ito. Okay, cubic centimeters. Okay, next. Okay, volume of a sphere. Okay, sphere. Ito, solid ito na bilog. Okay, sphere, yung mga halimbawa natin, yung bola. Bola ng basketball, bola ng volleyball. Okay? yung globe is an example of sphere. Okay? That is equal to, volume of a sphere is equal to 4 over 3 pi r cube. Or pwede, 4 times pi times r raised to 3 over 3. Again, our r is the radius. So imagine nyo yung ating circle here. Okay, yung radius doon sa gitnang-gitna ng sphere natin at papunta din sa surface ng sphere natin. Okay? Sa gitnang-gitna ng sphere, papunta ka sa surface ng sphere mo, yun yung radius mo. So, kung ito 3 yards, okay, remember kids, kung ito 3 yards, from the center of your sphere going up, nandito, 3 yards yan. From the center, papunta ka dito, same as true, 3 yards yan. From the center, pupunta ka dito, 3 yards din yan. From the center, punta ka dito, 3 yards din yan. Basta mahalaga na sa gitnang-gitna ng iyong figure, ang iyong point, okay? So, yung measure niyan, hanggang sa surface mismo ng iyong sphere, you have your radius there. Let's move. And find the volume of the figure on the right. We have, let's make use of this, 4 times pi, r over 3 over 3. Sorry, 4 times pi times r raised to 3 over 3. Okay? Substitute 4 times 3.14. Okay, remember, 3.14 pa rin. We round off to the nearest 2 decimal places. 3.14 times 3 raised to 3 over 3. Now, okay, pagkasuro ulit tayo, unahin natin ito. 3 raised to 3 is equal to 27. Remember, that is 3 times 3 times 3. Okay. So, 4 times 3.14 times 27 over 3. Pero unahin natin sa taas para mas madali. That makes it 339.12 over 3. 339.12 over 3. The answer will be 113.04 cubic yards. Okay, ayun lang. Salamat sa pakikinig. God bless you all. Ingat kayo lagi. Stay safe, guys. Happy night. God bless you.